The Olympics start this Friday, and for the first time ever, NBC, who owns the rights, is loosening their death grip on distributing content. Joining us to talk about this is Kurt Wagner, reporter at Recode. Welcome, Kurt.
Hi, Megan.
So tell us about the deal that was announced 3 months ago with Snapchat. Let's start there.
Sure. So a few months ago, NBC said that they were going to share some of their highlights onto Snapchat. And as part of the deal, BuzzFeed was going to kind of manage a Snapchat Discover channel for NBC, create the packages, and then NBC, of course, would say, you know, thumbs up, yes, you can use these highlights, which are really valuable, by the way. NBC pays billions of dollars for the rights to kind of own this content. And so even highlights were things that they never shared on any property that was not NBC owned. So that was a big deal. And that was a few months ago. And since then, they've recently announced another deal with Facebook and Instagram to share highlights over there as well. So we kind of are seeing the dissemination of this content, which again, NBC has paid a lot of money to own.
So will they be using their live streaming feature to show the highlights?
So this isn't going to be live in the way that we have been hearing a lot about what Twitter's doing. So you're not necessarily going to tune in and watch an actual competition live on Facebook or Snapchat. Instead, you would see stuff after the fact. But again, like that just goes to show you how important these highlights are to NBC, right? That even the fact that they're handing over highlights is a big deal. That kind of tells you a little something. So they were not willing to hand over the live streams. Those are the really valuable part that they want everyone to tune in to watch on television.
So you mentioned what Twitter's doing, but you mean what Twitter's doing with the NFL. You don't mean Twitter doesn't have a deal with the Olympics, do they?
Sorry, no, they don't. Yeah, I was referring to what Twitter's doing, not only with the NFL, but with a bunch of other partners. They're trying to create kind of this, you know, pseudo cable network, if you will, where they offer a bunch of different live streaming stuff. This is different than that. And again, I'm glad you brought that up. NBC does not have a deal with Twitter. In fact, that's kind of the one platform they were not able to get a deal together with. Even though they will share some highlights to Twitter, they will share some content to Twitter. It's going to be very different than what you're going to see them do with Facebook, Instagram, or with Snapchat.
So do you think it was it Twitter that didn't want? I mean, who was it, NBC, that didn't think Twitter was a valuable platform? Do you know anything about the deal?
Man, you're asking the right question, and it's one that I've asked as well without much luck of getting an answer. But I know that they talked. I know that when we reported about Snapchat and NBC coming together, they were in talks with both Facebook and Twitter. Something materialized with Facebook. It didn't with Twitter. It didn't with Twitter. I imagine, I'm totally guessing, I imagine there was some kind of hang-up over either how the money was going to be distributed or what they would be able to sell against the highlights versus not sell. I honestly do not know. But the fact that they didn't come to an agreement is kind of surprising, given I know that, you know, it seems like these are usually win-win for both sides. I can't imagine what kept them from doing it, but something did.
Yeah, it really seemed kind of made, you know, tailor-made for kind of Twitter's momentum in this thing that they've got going on right now. It's a missed opportunity for sure. Now, I cut the cord a couple of months ago, and since then, a lot of things have happened on TV that I want to watch. So basically, what I feel like I and fear that I'm hearing here is that, okay, there's clips, there's preview, you know, kind of highlights and all that kind of stuff that I, as a total cord cutter, could potentially have access to, but no live streaming of events in full. That's going to be next to impossible for me.
That's my understanding. So you're going to be able to watch it digitally through, I think it's NBCOlympics.com. They have an NBC Olympics app. And so there's a lot of ways you could watch it on like an iPad or an iPhone or even through like Apple TV. My understanding though is if you actually want to watch the good stuff, which is the actual competitions, you still need to authenticate, which means you would have to log in with your cable subscription, you know, username and password. So you're going to be able on a Facebook or a Snapchat to see what happened a couple hours ago, and you're going to probably see a lot of free talking heads, a lot of analysis. but if you want to see the real stuff, you're probably going to have to pay, you know, have NBC subscription, cable subscription in some way, shape, or form. I know. Boo. But yeah. That's why they paid. That's, I think, life. They paid like $4 billion for the rights to stream this. And they probably wouldn't be making a lot. It wouldn't be very good business to give it away for free. So
Absolutely.
I mean, I'm wondering if this is, I mean, Olympics used to, back in my day, the Olympics used to be such a big deal. I mean, just, but I don't know if people are that interested in them. There's so much, you know, controversy surrounding this, you know, this Olympics. There's doping and, do we really want our athletes out there when the pollution is so bad? I mean, I'm wondering, do you see this as a generational switch that younger people are not interested, or is the same interest there?
I'm with you. I think it's just gotten to be too big of business. It's, you mentioned doping. I mean, Russia's going through some doping issues. I remember a couple of years ago with China, there were all these issues with like their, you know, the Chinese gymnastics team was, it seemed like all the girls on the team were like 8 years old. This year, there's a bunch of top athletes in golf and LeBron James isn't playing for the NBA. Neither is Steph Curry. Like, people don't want to go to Brazil because they don't want to risk the Zika virus that's been going on. So like, there's a lot of things that are happening that are making it, I think, less appealing than it has been in the past, but none of it, in my opinion, is worse than the business side and how this has just become a big moneymaker, and it no longer feels like it's truly the place for the top athletes in the world to come and represent their country so much as it is a great marketing opportunity for NBC and for, all of their big brand partners who want to be involved. And I don't remember the exact outlet, but I want to say the Olympic committee sent out an email to a bunch of brands and was like, hey, if you sponsor an athlete, but you're not an official Olympic sponsor, you're not allowed to even like use certain hashtags on Twitter. So you couldn't say like, hey, we're proud of our long distance runner, so-and-so, hashtag Olympic Games. Like, you could get in trouble for doing that because you're not an official Olympic sponsor. And it's just ridiculous that this is all boiled down to, who can make the most money off of this. And we're not even, like I said, I'm bummed because we're not even seeing the best players in the NBA. We're not seeing the best golfers in the world. This is not a reflection of the best competition out there. And I think a lot of it has to do with corporate, greed, if I can get off my soapbox here. But that's a big bummer to me. Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, we talk about Twitter, whether they didn't want it. I mean, I'm interested because, I mean, the political race, the U.S. presidential race, is just like probably all Twitter needs at this point. I mean, that's a competition that we're all watching unfold and fall apart. And, oftentimes, it comes at the same year as the Olympics. So it's the Olympics are often like a more uplifting thing to watch than the political contest, which we definitely need this year. So maybe we'll have that. How are you going to watch it?
I will probably still watch on the big screen. By the big screen, I mean the television I have in my living room. But I was surprised at how much I enjoyed watching, you mentioned the convention stuff or the political stuff. Even though I think that if NBC was streaming actual competitions, I might be inclined to watch on a Twitter or Facebook, because I did enjoy seeing the live conversation directly beside the content of the conventions. Unfortunately, that's not available. So because of that, I'll probably watch on television. I don't really like watching sports on a phone. It's a little too small for me. So I'll probably stick with the traditional route. But we'll see. I don't know how much of it I'm going to watch in general, to be totally honest with you. I'm normally much more excited for the Olympics. And this year, some about it, I'm not quite as jazzed as I used to be. I must be sad from all the politics that's happening. That's the only explanation.
Yeah.
Well, Kurt, thank you so much for joining us. Kurt is a reporter at Recode.net, and he is Kurt Wagner 8 on Twitter. Thanks for coming on.
My pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kurt.